Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you. Lord, give you glory. Lord, give you honor. He says, as you said, as you rise and speak to your people, Father, oh Lord, let this word penetrate your people so that we may be saved on that day of the terrible day of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray, amen. My brothers and sisters, this is, of course, very, very terrible indeed, and, of course, shaking. And, of course, I don't know how it's going to be. The day of the Lord. The day of the Lord is near. The day of the Lord is near, my brother, my sister. Let every one of us get close to God. It shall be terrible indeed. And he said in Jeremiah, in chapter 1, verse 17, he said, there I should prepare myself to speak what is about to happen. And he has compelled me to say this, and I have no choice than to say it. What a terrible day of the Lord is coming. And my brother, I tell you, look, it's going to be terrible indeed. Oh Lord, help me to make it. Help me to make the day. Jesus. Jesus. Help me to make this day of yours. I don't want to miss heaven. I don't want to miss heaven. I want to go to heaven, Lord. Help me, prepare me for your time, your day. It shall be terrible indeed. Lord, help me. Help your people. Help my family. Help my wife. Help my children. For it shall be terrible indeed. When children will run to and fro, people run to and fro, rich men, poor men, they will run to and fro. Just seek for your mercy, and they will not see it. Lord, help us. Terrible day of the Lord. It will come. It will come. It will come. Now, please, if you read Daniel very well, after the coronavirus, I keep getting scared that what is going to happen. You can see Daniel chapter 12. When you read Daniel chapter 12, you see that Daniel said, knowledge will increase. And when knowledge increase, then you should watch out for the coming day. It's close by. And when you read Daniel very well, you see verse also 10, you see that he's talking about the sanctuary. Of course, the sanctuary will be shut down for 3 and, of course, months thereabout. And he did not actually, in that Daniel, you do not actually see the, of course, statement there or saying it there, but if you calculate what Daniel is saying there, he's talking about the sanctuary. Of course, we be closed down, and for some months, if you calculate 1,290 days, if you shed into 365 days, you see what is about to happen. And my brother, blessed are those that we, of course, make this great journey. Now, if you look at Zephaniah chapter 1:14, he's talking about the day of the Lord. It will be terrible indeed. And of course, my brother, it will consume both the belt, the heart. The heaven will shake, and of course, the people in this planet Earth, of course, the rulership everywhere will be shaking. And of course, when you also read the Bible very well, when you go to Second Peter, verse of course, 3:10, you also see the day of the Lord is coming. And so, when you look at Isaiah chapter 13, verse 6 to 13, you see that it's also talking about the terrible day of the Lord, and where, of course, people. The unbelievers will destroy sinners. And of course, the wickedness of the highest order, they will all be consumed, because the wickedness of man will be too much. And of course, they will all be consumed. The moon, the sun, the moon, the sun, we, of course, the moon, the sun will become dark. The moon will become blood. And it's also talking about the people will be destroyed. Also, if you look at still the day of the Lord, you look at Matthew, the Lord, you see Matthew. Matthew chapter 24, verse 1 to 51. You see Jesus Christ telling us about the timing and about his coming. And my brother, it will be terrifying indeed. And he was talking about, he actually gave us expo to see the timing, to see what is about to happen. And my brother, if you watch right now, you can see that both the media, the radio, the TV, and of course the social media, everywhere, the gospel is already everywhere, because the gospel is spreading very fastly. And please, my brother, he was talking about the day of his coming, and the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. Both young and old, everyone, of course, should be ready for this day. And if he's also talking about the hour, the timing, the hour. And you know, if you look also Luke chapter 21, from 1 to 37, you also see there he's talking about how false prophet will rise, how men we become lovers of themselves, lovers of the things of the world. Also, if you look at false prophets, we arose how many men of God, the elect one, will of course depart from the faith, and also how the elect one will be, of course, saved. Now, we are also looking at Mark chapter 13, verse 1 to 37. Also, it's talking about the day of the Lord, coming of Jesus. No demon can stop it. And I wonder, some of us who do believe in God, believe in Christ, you know that this is the gospel truth I'm saying. And the Satan that is deceiving you will take off. Satan will take off on that day. On that day, Satan will run away. He will run away. Satan will run away. He's leading you to doom. Satan has said he will never leave all these people who God has created. He will make sure every one of them will go with him. My brother, it shall be terrible day indeed. Terrible day indeed. Every day I cry to my God. I say, God, help me. Help me. I don't want to go to hellfire. I want to go to heaven. I don't want to go to hellfire. God, help me. God, help me. I don't want to go to hell. My brother, my sister, you are there. You are fornicating. You are committing adultery. You lie. You steal. You backbite. You cheat. Pastors are lovers of themselves. They are no more caring about how the members should go to heaven. Pastors, prophets. Hey, doing a lot of wrong things that God never wants. You see, pastors today, they want to get everything. They are not telling the member the truth. My brother, run away for your life. Run away. Run away for your life. Go to where you hear the gospel sound truth. I'm telling you the fact. The day of the Lord will be terrible. Very, very terrible. My brother, you can't wait to withstand it. I'm telling you the fact. God, help us. Help me. Help me and my people. Help us. For, oh Lord, we can't do it with our power. It's by your power, we can do it. And you can see today how people will dress to the church like a lot. People don't care anymore. You see, people design their hair anyhow, put tattoo in their body and come to the church. Know that the Bible said such thing will not make heaven, and pastors are not telling the people truth anymore. What pastors are doing is they're after their money and their purse. Speak the truth to the people, let them be saved. He said, I will hold you responsible. I will hold you responsible for all my lordship, all my lordship. Check the reminder you see there. My brother, I'm telling you the truth. The day of the Lord will be bloody, so bloody. Nobody can withstand it. I'm crying and I'm begging every one of us to repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. And when you look at Acts chapter 2, verse 17, 21, it's talking of afterwards the God will pour out his spirit upon all flesh. And when he do that, and of course, also, you can see looking for that, it's also talking about the taking over of the day of the Lord Jesus. After he pour out his spirit upon all flesh, many of us will rise to speak the truth to the people, and God will spare no one. After that, the day of the Lord is also coming. Look at the timing. If you look at Daniel very well, he was talking about the kingdom, the throne, how the new throne will arrive, how the former throne rulership will give support to the new throne. And when the new throne arrives, the Antichrist will penetrate, the spirit of Satan will penetrate into, and they will, all the evil counseled by the former throne, the new throne will reverse it, and my brother, it will be bloody. Sin will increase. Please, I beg you, in the name of God, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent to make heaven. Heaven is real. Heaven is real. Hell is real. Satan never wants you to go. He wants to pack everybody to hell, but thank God for the glory of God. For if you look at 1 Thessalonians from 1 to 4, and if you look at 10, it's talking about concerning the coming day of the Lord. And of course, the darkness day, pastors, bishop, we are looking at women and men, lovers of themselves, lovers of money, than the things of God. Bible says, be ye transformed. Don't be conformed with the things of the world. Be ye transformed from the renewal of your mind and soul and spirit. So many of you who are selling your soul to Satan. Satan will never do you anything. He wants to send you to hell. Give your life to Christ. Jesus is the only way, the truth, and the life. And when you look at Revelation chapter 13, when you look at Revelation very well, you see that the Antichrist made the rapture take place in the book of 1 Corinthians 15:52. And in the twinkling of an eye, in the moment, the trumpet of God will sound. Those who are filled with the Spirit of God will make heaven. Those who are not filled with the Spirit of God will go to hell. They will not be raptured. It shall be terrible indeed. The Antichrist will deceive you, tell you that you go to heaven, tell you that you enjoy yourself. Don't worry, there's no heaven, nothing. They are lying. No, he's lying. He's lying. He's lying. He will force you, both young, old, rich, and poor. He will force every one of you to receive the mark. You can't run away from it. But thank God to the glory of God. For the righteous one, for the elect one, the 144 sealed in verse 14, Revelation 14. And the righteous one, the people who are already born again, the people who are filled with the Spirit of God, we go. Lord, I want to be part of it. I want to experience it. Give me the strength to experience it. Give me the strength to experience it. Lord, I want to go to heaven. The book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 1, if you read from 1 to 5 or so, you see that the reason why Christ died is for us to be redeemed. To be redeemed. He has redeemed us. He has saved us, that we may have right with him. It is only through Jesus. If you shall confess your sin, Jesus Christ will save you. Don't listen to any man that will deceive you. There are many people to deceive you, and they will not tell you the truth because they know they have been confirmed with the world. They've received the Illuminati set up. Look, when you see any man of God having rings in their hand, these are people that have already sold out. Please, my brother, listen to me. Some of them don't care the way you dress, the way you appear, the way you do things. They don't care. They don't care. It's their money they are looking for. My brother, run away for your life. No unclean things will enter heaven. No unclean things will enter heaven. My brother, watch out, watch out. Satan is coming at the rooting and looking for who to before looking for who to take to hell. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus for so many of you want to give your life to Christ, you want to serve God. God will definitely save you on that day. Just say it with me. Father, I receive you. Jesus, I receive you. Save me on that day. Save me right now. On that day can be the day of the Lord can be your day. If you die, you go to hell. If you die without Christ, you go to hell. Please repent. Repent and say after me, Lord Jesus, I want to repent. I don't want to sin anymore. I want to follow you to the last. Save my soul. Save me. I'm crucified with you. Save me. Let me be on that day. Because the Bible said in the book of course, Revelation chapter 14, after the 144 seal, he also promised with the great nation Gentiles, the great nation of people who will be saved too. I want to be part of them. Just say, Lord Jesus, I want to be part of them. Where your mind is where your treasure is. If your treasure is in heaven, you make heaven. If your treasure is not there, or if your mind is not there, you don't make heaven. Please let your treasure be there. I'm going to drop from now. My brother, I'm crying every day through my heart that God should use me to save soul. Use me to save soul. And most especially, many of us who are listening to me right now, give your life to Christ. Give your life to Christ. Give your life to Christ. God loves you so much. That's why he died for your sin, that you may have everlasting life. And I do believe in the mighty name of Jesus. As so many of us who believe in this world, you shall be set free indeed. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. God bless every one of you. God bless you. Continue to serve God. Hope on God. And continue to live a holy and righteous life. With that wish, nobody will see God. God bless you.